called, isn't it? You know how to play the song, Father Abraham has many songs. Father Abraham has many songs. Many songs. You're not there. Let's go for that. I want you to stand up. I want you to stand. I'm going to warm you up first. So we're going to stand and read our Bible again, in same book, Book of Acts, chapter 2, verse 37. Can I have a volunteer this side to wait for us? Anybody that wants to wait for us this side? Thank you.
And having heard, they were pricked in heart, and to Peter and the other apostles, what shall we do, brethren? And Peter said to them, repent and be baptized, each one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for remission of sins, and ye will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit.
Thank you very much. So, you may be seated. Thank you. So we're going to continue with the same message again, experience. With your own personal experience. I'm going to go over it again. For you to catch what I'm trying to say. It's very important. Personal experience is given the basis of Christianity. You're not even a Christian yet if you haven't made your own personal experience. Do you know that? Rabbi Adam says so. You can't even call yourself a Christian. Who's a Christian here? But when I say to be a Christian, you have to make your own personal experience. It's very important. So by reading the book of Acts, when Jesus was on earth, before going, there was a man, they were there, the disciples. They were following Jesus. They were doing what Jesus said to them to do. Some of them even went to preach. Some of them did miracles. But there was something missing. They needed their personal experience. Even though they weren't preaching, even though they were doing miracles, they were following Jesus, but they lack a personal experience. There are so many people coming in this message. You know we have a special message. Do you know the message? The message brought to us by the prophet, by the Brahman. There are many people, young people like you and me, coming in the message, following this message, maybe following our parents, maybe playing the music, singing, even preaching, we are following Brother Brandon, but still, they're missing something, their own personal experience. Because once you've made your own personal experience, nothing will ever shake you. And it's very good, but when you say, it's very good for you to do your personal experience when you're still young. There's a certain age where Brother Branham said we can become a Christian, you can accept this message. After passing that certain age, it's very difficult. An easier age for you to receive the message, for you to make your own personal experience when you're young. And there is a blessing following after that. Now, these disciples, they were doing miracles. Maybe like some of us preaching. Maybe it's like some of us doing miracle, praying for people. But they still needed to make their own personal experience. They were following Jesus. Peter was Peter, he was a very strong man, Peter. And when they came to arrest Jesus, Peter was so angry, he got up, took a knife, and chopped one of the guards in the ear. Peter needed an experience. And when Jesus was arrested, they took him. Peter was following Jesus. Now, at that time, Peter was a bit scared. You know, he chopped someone's ears, even though Jesus brought it back. And their master, who was Jesus, was arrested. Peter was following. And he got somewhere where Jesus was. They were beating him there. He sat somewhere. And there was one woman who sat next to him. He looked at him. He said, it looks like you look like one of those people following Jesus. They looked at that girl. You look like a message believer, the way you dress. You look like a brother from this message. Do you follow Parabana? And what did Peter do? No, he denied. Peter denied. He looked at you and said, are you a Christian? No, I'm not a Christian. If you want to be like that, everyone. You see, you want to be, because you're around your friends who act differently than the way he did, and you're trying to copy them, you know. He said, I look at this as a Christian, he's a sissy man. No, I'm not a Christian. I'm not, you see. You're acting like Peter. Now, Peter was afraid. And what happened? After he went to pray and receive and did his own personal experience with God, Peter was not afraid anymore. Back in those days, they were looking to kill them. They were looking to arrest them. They were all afraid. They went to hide and stop someone in a house. They went in that place, they hid themselves there because they were afraid Jesus was arrested. Maybe the police are looking for them too. So they were all scared. Peter denied Jesus. How many times did he deny him? Was it 3 times? Imagine Peter denying his messenger, Jesus. So Peter missed him. He needed his personal experience. So when Peter went in that chamber, they were praying, waiting, because Jesus said, tarry here, and I will send you a comforter, the Holy Spirit, before they could even go and preach. Imagine they were preaching, they were doing miracles, they were so happy. But before Jesus going back to heaven, Jesus told them to tarry, to wait until they have been filled with the Holy Spirit, until they have made their own personal experience. Because Jesus knew without that, they would be lying like Peter did. They would be running away, telling the lies. But Jesus told them to wait. And when they wait, they were there in the room in the book of Acts, chapter 2. You can go home and read the whole chapter. They were all filled with the Holy Spirit. They all made their own personal experience. And after that, Peter came out from that chamber. He was not afraid anymore. You can read the whole book of Acts. You find Peter doing the work of God. Peter who was scared, Peter who denied Jesus 3 times, from then on, he had the strength to stand for what he believed. No matter what those people said, no matter what the king or whatever said, Peter stood on the message that Jesus preached to them after making his own personal experience. That comes to you and I. After making our own personal experience, we will stand no matter what people say. No matter how people criticize us, no matter how people call us, no matter whatever name we give you, you will stand with the message. Amen. Are you with me? Yes. You will stand with me. Like Peter. Peter made his personal experience, and Peter was not afraid anymore. He was not ashamed of his message. He was not ashamed of Jesus. Okay? So it's very, very important to make your own personal experience. Now, when Peter made that experience, people were speaking in tongue. You know what I mean by people speaking in tongue? Do you know what I mean by people speaking in tongue? They were people speaking other language. People didn't understand it. A lot of people thought they were drunk after making the experience. A lot of people thought they were drunk. What's wrong with these people? Look at them. You talk about Jesus, they are screaming and shouting, talking in different tongues, in different languages that we don't understand. And some of them came and asked Peter, as we read it at the sermon. Peter told them before that, Peter told them, we're not drunk. To say we are not drunk, like you think we are not drunk. Because the matter, the honest, when you make your honest personal experience, people will think you're drunk. And people will think you're drunk, because things you'll be saying, things you'll be doing, people will say like this person. You see, this message, to be a Christian, not everyone will like you. This is one thing you need to remember. When you're a Christian, not every friend that you've got will be your friend. You'll be different from them. That's why we thank God we have this message, we have the church, we have brothers and sisters here, we've got friends here that we can come and comfort ourselves here that we are here Christian. But out there, people will don't. When you speak about Christianity, the way religion nowadays is just it's something that you can't speak about it. They hate it. They don't like it. They don't want to hear anything about Christianity. They don't want to hear anything special about this message. You're going to tell them that God has sent us a prophet. A prophet? Yes, but they don't. Some people say, yeah, I heard that man, but the way you guys behave, you don't dress this way. You people, you don't go this place. You don't play like this. You people always talk about the Bible every time. Sometimes we need to talk about this. See? They want you to be like them. But once you, after making your own personal space, you are a different person. You are a new person. You are a new person. So, people came to ask Peter, what shall we do? We want to make our own personal experience as well. Who want to make their own personal experience? We all want to make our own personal experience. But what shall we do, Peter? Tell us, for us to make our own personal experience. For us to have faith. Remember, Brother Branham said, the one we read last Sunday, that faith comes by experience. For you to have faith in Brother Branham, you need to make your own experience. Without that, as I said last Sunday, I've seen a lot of people falling down. I've seen a lot of people leaving the message because of missing the most important part, the basic part. People are neglecting the most important part of the experience. That's why in most jobs, you can't get, you go to a job, you can't get a job because you lack experience. If you miss your 10-year lab experience, work experience that you do, it's very difficult for you to get the same kind of job you want to do with that experience. Are you with me? So ask Peter, what shall we do? Peter said, repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of sin. Okay, Peter, what shall we do? What's the answer? What's the answer that Peter gave? Repent, every one And be what? In the name of Jesus. That's a step for you to make your own personal experience. For you to make your own experience. Like Peter and the rest of them did. After the experience, they were not afraid. David, after the experience with the lion, killing the lion, as we read last Sunday, and killing the bear, David was not afraid of Goliath, the big guy. He looked at all the soldiers of Israel, they were all scared. They were all there hiding themselves. And David, a very small young boy, imagine David was a boy at that time. He wasn't a man, but when he said he was a young boy, like you and me, young, not old. That's why to make your personal experience, you don't need to be old. Like some young people have made, they say, no, that's for old people, not me, I'm still young, I need it. David was still young when he made the experience. And David, when he made that, he saw that Goliath, he said, I will face him. He was young, he wasn't old. That's why I'm saying you're still young for you. Maybe some of you are the same age as David. It's time for you to make your own personal experience like David. And first, Goliath, in this generation, you might not have a long tall person, but face whatever friend is telling you, whatever word this world is bringing onto you, the new fashion dress, the new whatever. The things that are taking you out of the world of God will help you be able to face it after your own personal experience. David was young. So he asked Peter. Peter said, repent, each one, every one of you, and be baptized in the name of Jesus for the remission of your sin. And ye shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. After doing those steps that Peter has given to us, I hope we're all going to do it for us to receive, to make our own personal experience, is to repent and be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of our sin, and we shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. Now, you might wonder, what's the Holy Ghost? Now, these people who leave the message by themselves, no wonder they're falling off. People think they can leave this message by themselves. People think they can do the word of God by themselves. You can't. You will never, never, never be able to leave this message by yourself. Saying that, okay, I've read this one, I do it. It becomes like a law to you. After receiving the Holy Ghost, which is Jesus Christ in you. That's why I remember last time I said, you are the Jesus. For people to see the Jesus now, they have to see you. After making, repent, be baptized in Jesus Christ for the remission of your sin, then Jesus will come and live in you. And then I can call you Jesus. I can call you my brother, I can call you my sister, I can call you Christian. Say Barbara. So those are the steps that Peter gave to everyone to follow, to make their own personal experience so that fear can go away from us. To be ashamed of this message can go away from us. We will not be afraid to speak of this message, to speak about our brother, to even call our friends to come to church. Talk about the message with your friends. You see, sometimes people are so ashamed to talk about the message to their friend. Whoever talk about the message to their friend, good, that's good. You shouldn't be ashamed of it. Tell them. Speak to them. Tell them. Tell your friend, yes, we have received the message. God has sent us a prophet. Come and listen to the message. give them the spoken word. Because something you can ask your dad or mom, it's free to get it. Just give them to them to go and read it. You yourself, you need to read it. You see? So after making that, you'll be like Peter, who was afraid, who was denying before, and is not afraid anymore. And you'll be standing with the message. So for you to make your own personal experience, Peter gave us an advice. They came, people wanted, when they saw that people was murdered, they were asking themselves, wow, what's that? And they all wanted to be that, to receive the same thing. And they asked Peter, what shall we do? What shall we do? He said, repent, remember it, don't forget, and be baptized in Jesus Christ for the remission of your sins. Excuse me, and you shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost, which is Jesus Himself in you. Amen. So, to end there, remember, Saul didn't have an experience. Even though he knew in his head, he memorized the whole Bible, he memorized the whole technique. He had it in his head, but Saul did not have any experience at all. He just knew in his head. We don't want people that know the message just in his head, their head. They memorize it, they can memorize. Yes, in book, in so-and-so book, is in verse so-and-so, and this, this is what it says. They're memorizing it. They put it in their head. So he had it there. But he, when he came to put that in action, he was afraid. He couldn't do that. Oh, so you know how to fight. Now go and fight Goliath. Well, let's wait. And Goliath was there, swearing at them. People were looking at Saul. You are the only one who is able. See? He just knew it in his head. And we don't want Christians like that. That just know the message in head, but they don't want you to apply that message. You know the verses in your head. The verses says this, the Bible says this, thou shalt not kill, thou shalt not steal, but he knows the whole Ten Commandments. Who knows the Ten Commandments? You all know the Ten Commandments. Knowing the whole Ten Commandments, but they're not applying the Ten Commandments. It's not about knowing the Ten Commandments, but it's about putting it in action. When the first Ten Commandments say, you shall not worship, you shall not call any other God. Is that what he said? But people are doing that. When he says you shall not kill, people are killing. But the person knows the Ten Commandments there. What don't you do it? You shall not steal, but people are stealing. Why? That's like Saul, who has no experience. No wonder, young boy, that poor, you guys are here, after making your own personal experience, it won't just be in your head, but it will be in your actions, in your way of doing. You know the Ten Commandments say you shall not kill, or kill, or not kill somebody. I will not steal. I will not do this, I will not do that, which is against the word of God. Be like David. Be like Peter. He was afraid before. He chopped somebody's head. He preached, but he lacked his experience. He lacked Jesus in him. Once you have Jesus in you, you will not be perfect. It won't be you who doing the job. It won't be you who follow the message, but it will be Christ, Jesus in you, doing what the word of God says. It will be easier for you. People are finding it hard to leave the message. It's because they don't know God and know Jesus in them. That's why they're finding it hard to leave the message. But once God is in you, it will be something easy for you to leave. When something, a certain thing happens, comes to you, you will know, now this I can do, and this I cannot do, this I cannot do, this one I can do. God in you, living in you. Amen. So we come to the end there. Any question? Any question? What's the advice that Peter gave to us? You can all take your Bible and read it for me there in verse 52. 38, so chapter 2, verse 88. Just verse 88. Can all read it? So I want you, when you go home, go and read it again. Just read that verse. Go and read that verse again. Read it again. Read it again. And I don't want it to be just in your head. Remember, Saul had the message in his head, but he couldn't put it in actions. Are you with me? This verse, it will be in your head. Yes, but I don't want you just to stay there. You don't want that message to stay there. And we want to put what Peter said in action. Okay? We want to put what Peter said in action. So look, find yourself, go and read it and see what you can do to put that one, that verse in action, and for you to make your own personal experience with God. And from there on, thank God, you can call yourself a Christian now. Yeah? Good. We're going to pray. Sing the song and pray. Singing, yeah.